from Kilmarnock sets off the semi-final replay as Aberdeen bid for their fourth consecutive cup final. And go straight into the attack. There's Steve Cowan. The tackle came from Morris Malpass. And that certainly warms the hearts of the travelling Aberdeen fans. Alec McLeish sprinting forward to the goal line. Billy Stark is in the box. There's Steve Cowan with the in-swinger. Taken easily by McAlpine for Dundee United. And he would welcome that early touch of the ball. Aberdeen have the luxury of starting the match with exactly the same 11 players as the ones who started on Saturday. But Dundee United have had to make some changes. Aberdeen, though, with their front three unchanged, particularly the men to break the deadlock. For them are Black, Hewitt and Cowan, supported, though, from midfield by Billy Stark, the goals machine in midfield with 18 so far this season. United have brought back Ralph Milne wearing a number 8 in place of Alec Taylor, who's left out of Saturday's side. And they're of course without their captain Paul Hegarty, injured on Saturday, with Richard Goff joining David Neary in central defence. And wearing Hegarty's number 5 is Stuart Beattie, who started the match in midfield. Simpson's header on. There's Cowan. Well, pass battling hard. McKimmy's playing at left back despite wearing number 2 for Aberdeen. Here's Dougie Bell. Now Malpass. Beattie's interception, a chase for Dodds with McLeish. Van Leighton in trouble. Alec McLeish furious with him for not coming to meet the ball at the edge of the box. And you'll see here how dangerous a ball like this can be as Beattie plays it through. McLeish going for it. Now Leighton chose to stay in his goal line. That posed problems for McLeish on the bumpy Tynecastle surface. Let off for Leighton. But the playing surface may well play a part in proceedings tonight. It's certainly much firmer than it was on Saturday, but not very true. And here goes Ralph Milne. A second chance for Milne after that fine Leighton save. And Neil Cooper doing a splendid job in defence for Aberdeen. So thank you to Cooper from his defensive colleagues. Ralph Milne's pace almost broke down the Aberdeen defence. Now Goff going forward. Bannon's corner. Stark with a comfortable header clear. What a hectic start to the match. Here's Eric Black, tried to release Hewitt on the right, but Beattie picked it up. United retained possession, going back to Morris Malpass. Here's Sturrock in behind McKimmy. An uncompromising challenge from Willie Miller, and the Aberdeen captain will be spoken to by referee Alexander. Paul Sturrock's first real involvement in the match, one of those splendid turns. And Miller acknowledges the warning from the referee. Well, here's what it was all about. Sturrock trying to turn past Miller to the right flank. Well, no let up at all in the early action. The first game hailed as a disappointment in many quarters, but well, the crowd is somewhat diminished tonight. They've had plenty to shout about in these opening stages. United still on the attack. There's Paul Sturrock. The opening goal for Dundee United. Sturrock celebrates, and the referee appears to be calling someone to him. No, the goal will stand all right, and the United supporters celebrate in style. So the throw-in set all off. Now just watch how this ball bounces when it hits the deck beyond Neil Cooper. Had bounced over the Aberdeen defence. There was Sturrock with a glancing header, and Leighton had no chance at all. Neary heading it wide for Malpass. It's good play from Malpass, creating space for Neary at the back. The Rods in quickly on McLeish, but it's retrieved by Cowan for Aberdeen. Bell getting away from Kirkwood, but not from Beattie. I think Bell was a shade fortunate there because he had lost control of the ball as he ran out of space towards the touchline. No question about the foul though. And it's Alec McLeish with the free kick. It's gone by Black, there's Stewart. Well taken by McAlpine. But the menace of Eric Black clear for all to see. McLeish with the long, far-flung free kick. It was Black who won it, Hewitt got the header in, and McAlpine was there. Cowan's header, there's Hewitt, and Black, and Cowan is free in the left, Neri using all his pace to get back. Well, he did just enough to halt the progress of Steve Cowan. That'll be a corner kick, yes, it came off Neri eventually. So Aberdeen's corner kick. Cooper, Miller and McLeish have made their way into the box. United have pulled every player back to defend. Cooper forcing it forward, there's Black. And Aberdeen's first clear striking goal falls to Eric Black. But no luck at all, it came from the corner kick. Now United scrambled to get this ball clear. It broke awkwardly off Holt, played forward by Cooper. It broke again towards Black. He's winning back in his shot. It's over the top. Stark to Simpson. Good play again from the United midfield. Kirkwood and Beattie very active indeed in that area. Here's Sturrock. Well, that would have been a fine goal. The pass from Milne controlled on the thigh by Sturrock. Two touches Paul Sturrock had to this ball as it comes forward from Milne. You see him control it, then an instant shot over the top. Eric Black, Nobel, Simpson arriving on the far side. Simpson's cross, there goes Black. The header from Cowan, he was offside anyway, but Cowan found some space in the 6-yard box. Headed across to him by Dougie Bell. Cross came in from Neil Simpson. Black got up a long way, it was Bell's header which found Cowan offside at the far side. Well read by Holt. Bannon linking with Dodds. And there will be a booking for Neil Cooper. Bannon played the ball inside, made for the return and was body checked by Cooper. And that's why the young Aberdeen defender is the first player in the match to be booked. Bannon and Simpson clash, and the verdict goes to Aberdeen. McLeish's free kick. Looking for Black. He was well beaten that time by Holt. Black making for the byline, and he's won the corner kick off John Holt. Aberdeen coming much more into the match as they press for the equaliser. Corner kicks from the right from John Hewitt have certainly posed problems for Dundee United. Vicious in-swingers. There it goes again. Billy Stark couldn't reach it. Kimmy gets it back to Miller. Handball was it from Malpass? Yes, referee Alexander was right on the spot. Certainly was outside the box, so it's a free kick to Aberdeen. He stays in the box. Miller and Hewitt. Hewitt takes it, there's Black. Crowded penalty area, blocking Black's header. C Simpson and Beattie together, and the treacherous surface plays havoc again for Neil Simpson. Here's Sturrock. Well, he had to hurry the shot as Willie Miller arrived, but I'm sure he'll be disappointed with that one. Set up by Beattie's diligence on the left, shrugging off Simpson, playing it into the path of Sturrock. You see Miller getting back very quickly indeed, hurrying Sturrock into the shot. Put up perhaps by Kirkwood, the referee allowing play to go on as Aberdeen still have possession. Kimmy works the 1-2 with Cowan. There's McLeish. That'll be a corner kick. So once again, a crowded Dundee United penalty area. Even Paul Sturrock is back defending. Header from Cowan. Well, no, it came off a United defender, and that's another corner kick. This corner kick took a deflection from Milne, and it came off the head of a defender. Looked like Stuart Beattie. Cowan playing it to the near post. Sturrock with the clearance. Simpson. Misunderstanding there with Bell. Sturrock, a very accurate ball through the middle. And just as well for Aberdeen that William Miller was alive to that, otherwise Kirkwood was free. This goal kick from Jim Leighton may well bring the first half to a close. First half in which United undoubtedly have taken the honours. They seized the initiative right from the kickoff. Indeed, there goes the half-time whistle. United going off to tremendous applause from the fans behind the goal to our right, and thoroughly deserved at that. United, good value for that. One goal half-time lead came about in just 5 minutes. The throw on the left came in, Cooper couldn't get to it, it bounced very high. Sturrock took full advantage with a very accurate header, and that's the goal which has given Dundee United that vital half-time lead. Don't go away, we'll be right back. Through Tynecastle. As United start the second half, 45 minutes away from the cup final. Aberdeen no doubt deliberating at half-time, with Alec Ferguson now back down on the bench. He no doubt would have been working hard at half-time to reorganise things to break down this United side, which was outstanding in midfield. Came off the head of Ralph Milne. But Aberdeen lost the early initiative when they allowed Kirkwood, Beattie and Bannon to take a grip of the vital midfield area. Hewitt with the ball inside, there's Simpson, now Cooper. And still at one goal for Aberdeen, Neri's header out. Well, some great play from John Hewitt on the Aberdeen left. That was so close to the equaliser. Pressure is still on the United defence. Simpson forcing his way forward, he's back now with Bell. Back to McKimmy, who made a good angle for Bell. Now Miller. Bit of pushing in the middle. And the free kick is given to Dundee United. Well, that really was very close indeed for Aberdeen. Some brilliant play out on the left as John Hewitt hit the byline, pulled it back. That's a great dummy from Steve Cowan. In came Simpson, he couldn't get a clean strike at the ball. Cooper came in, good tackling by John Holt, and eventually it was David Neri's header clear. The head flick on from the start, he was taken late by Kirkwood. It was a reckless challenge that will result in another booking. Billy Stark has taken the headlock, he's on the deck, and Kirkwood booked. Alec Ferguson to his feet. Here's why Billy Kirkwood's in the referee's book, going in very high on Billy Stark. Dodge to Kirkwood. The deception was by McKimmy. Very sound defending indeed by young Stuart McKimmy. Now Hewitt. Fine tackle by Neary. Well timed and very incisive. Here's Ralph Miller. Down he goes, the tackle from Cooper. Now Cooper is in serious trouble. Alec Ferguson is on his feet on the bench. Now Cooper has been booked before. This will be a red card. Alec Ferguson is irate on the track. He clearly feels that there was nothing malicious in that challenge from Cooper. But it looks as though Aberdeen are about to be reduced to 10 men. Well, here's the tackle which caused the offence. Milne, by sleight of foot, went past Cooper. Cooper went in late. Down goes the United striker. And the protests still go on from Neil Cooper to referee Alexander. Alec McLeish making his plea to the referee also. But inevitably, Aberdeen are reduced to 10 men. Off goes Neil Cooper. His second booking of the match. And there must be a degree of sympathy felt for the young Aberdeen defender. That tackle certainly was misjudged, but wasn't malicious. And free kick there by Aberdeen. Now Aberdeen have the toughest of all tasks, trying to retrieve this semi-final tie against the United side, clearly on form, and now with only 10 men to set about the task. The Aberdeen supporters, to their great credit, raising their voices in support. They give additional encouragement to their favourites. But if the task was tough enough with 11 men, surely now with 10, it will be well nigh impossible. Steve Cowan has taken a knock. Aberdeen physio, maybe Welly is on. Well, pass with the free kick. Simpson with the header, that's Billy Kirkwood. Stark is dropped back into the left back position, vacated by Cooper. Cooper is only the second Aberdeen player this season to be ordered off. The other was Stuart McKimmy against Rangers in January, but here's McKimmy now coming forwards with Bell inside. Bell again. Another short, didn't really test Hamish McAlpine. Kirkwood into space for Milne. Miller is stranded for Aberdeen. Sturrock and Dodds waiting in the middle. Bannon coming late. And what a goal from Beattie! Stuart Beattie, 14 and a half minutes into the second half. It's 2-0 to United, and that one almost burst the net. Well, this was down to the extra man in attack. Cooper is off the field. Milne has all the space in the world to sprint forward to the byline, but just wait for this volley from Beattie, taken with the left foot, blistering shot to the roof of the net. So 2-0 to Dundee United. Stuart Beattie with his fifth goal of the season, capping a splendid performance in the United midfield. Substitution now for Aberdeen. Tommy McQueen has gone on to play at left back, no doubt. John Hewitt has gone off. And what can Aberdeen do about this situation? Two behind and reduced to 10 men. The grim face of Alec Ferguson on the Aberdeen bench. Cowan playing it back, but there's Dodds. Putting pressure on Villa. Dodds made no contact as he clashed with Willie Miller, and Alec Ferguson again is on his feet on the track, incensed by the tackle from Davy Dodds, which will, I think, earn the United player a booking. Ferguson absolutely furious. Davy Dodds certainly did not play the ball as he came across. Now Miller was out of reach. Dodds clearly appeared to have that situation under control. He missed the ball out altogether and played Willie Miller. And that's what has incensed the Aberdeen bench and resulted in Davy Dodds seeing the red card. Davy Dodds goes off. And that United reduced to 10 men. Well, it was a bad tackle by Dodds. Tim McLean looks impassive in the director's box. But Davy Dodds departs and makes the match 10 against 10. Been playing it through the middle, though, in there for Aberdeen. There is Burns. And steals it back from McKimmy. Now for Aberdeen, pushing everyone forward, including McLeish. Only leaving McKimmy back now as Simpson lines up the cross. Cowan tried the shot, he was tackled by Malpass in the act of shooting. A late tackle by Malpass. That's been the saddest feature of tonight's play, the number of reckless challenges going in late after the ball's been played forward. There's leaving the foot in, coming on with the tackle. Now there will be a substitution for Dundee United. Ralph Milne has done enough, but he won't get a chance to come off. The referee hasn't spotted that. What a save by McAlpine. It came from Eric Black. And that just about settles things for Dundee United, I think. Free kick played forward, a prodigious leap by Black, a flashing header, and great handling by McAlpine. Now Black, taking on Holt and winning the corner kick. The time very much the enemy for Aberdeen. Ian Angus with the corner kick. The only man at the near post area was David Neary. Finish in the box, a hopeful dive, ignored by the referee. There's Simpson. Precise header from Cowan. And no luck at all for the big striker, finding McAlpine right on the spot. Set up by McLeish's challenge. Good play here from Neil Simpson, showing a lot of control and composure. The accurate ball inside, a good firm header, but McAlpine was there. Once again, United Aberdeen have earned the corner kick on the right. Neil Simpson will take it. McLeish helping it on to McQueen. Here's Miller making for the byline. Off Malpass. A great goal from Angus. That was as good a volley as you'll ever hope to see. 4 minutes of the match left. Can Aberdeen pull this match out of the fire? Well, this is a volley you'll not tire of seeing. Deflection from Malpass. Another defensive header from Goff. A stunning volley from Angus, and Aberdeen have a fleeting chance now to save the tie. A tremendous cup tie. Aberdeen, for the first time virtually since Paul Sturrock put United ahead in the fifth minute, seeing a glimmer of hope. United have to retain their composure in these closing seconds. Shank just to get on with it, playing the ball forward. Came off Bowman. It was Eric Black. Cowan is through the middle, Simpson is there too. Aberdeen finding new strength in the legs as they get men forward from midfield. A corner kick has been awarded, and this will result in a cavalry charge from the back, I'm sure. There goes McLeish. Miller is also making his way forward. Not one Aberdeen player left outside the box except Neil Simpson on the tee of the 18-yard box. Galpin missed it. There goes Simpson. It didn't break kindly, but it's a corner kick once again. What a finish to the match. Can Aberdeen do it? Drawing in all the reserves of courage and stamina. 2 minutes left. Angus with the corner. Collected from McAlpine. He was fouled by two Aberdeen players. Such was their anxiety and determination. They bumped the keeper in the act of gathering the ball. The singing you hear is from the Aberdeen supporters. Even if it turns out to be defeat, there will be no disgrace. Anthony Alexander checking his watch very carefully indeed, but there have been stoppages in the second half. There should be time added on. It goes through towards Cowan with a hand used. The referee says no. He's being mobbed now by the Aberdeen players. The police still thumping the ball forward for Tommy McQueen. Out it goes for the throw. What a controversial minute to end a dramatic match. And that wasn't far away, played in by McQueen over the top. And that may well be Aberdeen's last chance. Bitterly disappointed that referee Alexander did not see a hand used as the ball was played into the United box. I must say, I didn't see it either, although it came back awkwardly from a United player. Challenge came from McLeish, and there goes the final whistle. Dundee United are in the...